This week, I thought I'd redesign my desk setup since I spend so much time editing and making music here. Now, the goal is simple. It needs to save me as much time as possible while taking up as little space as possible. So let's quickly run through the setup and then I'll get into how it actually saves me time. We start with this desk. It's 31 by 31 inches, which is pretty small so that I can free up space in the rest of the room. Now the challenge is to fit everything on it. So I screwed some legs onto a piece of scrap wood, which will give me some extra storage space underneath. I also added a little eye bolt and cable clip on the underside of the desk, and we'll use those later. For the computer, I'm using a 2013 iMac, but obviously it's all the same no matter what machine you're using. And for the speakers, I've got these M-Audios, definitely not the best, but still decent. Next, we'll add an audio interface and a microphone that can clamp onto the side of the desk. All of the products are listed in the description, by the way. So then I've got a jack cable hanging on a door, a MIDI controller for percussion, and a keyboard, which I'm leaving on the side because my rule is that it can only live on the desk if I use it more than once a week. Then I made this weird thing, which is just a cheap spice rack that can actually hold two hard drives as long as you use zip ties to keep them in place. Now remember those screws? That's where we can hook in the spice rack, meaning that the drives don't take up any of our precious desk space. Then we've got this six big 48 terabyte drive, which Lacey sent me, and I use that for the main media storage. Next up is this pen tablet, which I use for graphics, a card reader to bring in new footage, and a USB hub for some extra ports. I'll also sit some SD cards within reach. Then we'll add a keyboard, a trackball mouse, and a fire extinguisher, which I've heard is worth doing when there's all these electronics about. And last of all, a wireless charger for my phone. So now we have to plug everything in. And the quickest way to demonstrate this is with a big diagram. Feel free to pause the video if you care about this stuff, because I'm getting bored of it. Okay, so here's the thought behind why it's been set up like this. It's all about time. I spend most of my day writing, editing, or handling emails about future projects, and I can do all of that with the setup as is. Hard drives and speakers, everything's all plugged in and ready 24 hours a day. Even the card reader, which is in constant use. But I can also just pull the mic into position so I can talk and in a couple of clicks change the audio output to these earbuds so that I can hear, which is good because I usually have at least 3 Skype calls per week. Then I can grab the pen tablet and turn it on, which happens about twice a week when I'm doing drawings or animations, so it's good to have that really quick to access. But there's some stuff that doesn't need to be so readily available, so I don't mind moving these out of the way to bring in the keyboard from the side and using the cable from the audio interface when I want to record music, because that only happens about once a week. And it's the same reason why I keep the MIDI controller underneath the pen tablet, because it gets used maybe once a fortnight when I want to record percussion. And finally, the most time-consuming change is if I want to go and get a guitar and cable, and then I can record electric guitar, which only happens once a month, so I don't mind that I have to actually get up and plug a lot of stuff in. The point is that anything I need to do every day is already set up to go, and then the less often I use something, the more time I'm willing to spend setting it up. It's a case of priorities, and it means that everything is purely functional. It has a purpose and nothing extra. For me, that's much more important than whether I've hidden all the cables and made it all symmetrical. Now, over the past year or so, I started keeping all of my projects and files rather than deleting the old ones, because you never know when they might come in handy. But of course, that can eat up a lot of space. So at the moment, I store my project files and operating system on the internal drive, which backs up to a 4 terabyte external drive sitting on the spice rack. And then I store all of the media on the drive that Lacey sent me, which is in RAID 5, meaning it's fast, but if one drive fails, I can replace it without losing data. And for now, that's backing up to an 8 terabyte USB drive, but obviously I will need to get a bigger backup drive once I get close to 8 terabytes of media. Now, it goes without saying that plenty of this is expensive stuff, and I'm really not saying that everyone needs this. plenty of editors will be fine with, say, 4 terabytes of backed up storage and a less powerful computer. It really just depends on how much work you're doing and how much you're earning from it. I've slowly upgraded this stuff over the years. For ages, I was using a really cheap pen tablet, USB hard drives, and a crappy mini keyboard. But as I found myself using them more often and actually earning money from them, it eventually made sense to upgrade. But even so, the computer and speakers are 4 years old, and I've been using that card reader for 5 years. The table was secondhand, and I literally found the chair in a skip. So obviously your own setup will be tailored to your own budget and your own needs, but hopefully this might have given some ideas for how to think about prioritizing the things that you spend the most time doing. My name's Simon Cade, this has been DSLRguide, and I'll see you next week.